What's the Buzz podcast presents America's Best Podcast. This is an interesting, very unique show, Amelia Pitbull Chapman. Yes. Unique in that we're going to do something we've never done before. And you can tell by the intro, we're already kind of doing something different.
Yes.
At this time, you would hear me screaming, it's 6 o'clock in here and it's 4 o'clock in here. Well, we don't care what time it is right now, but it's time to talk about our favorite Christmas gifts, Amelia Pitbull-Chapman. Did I just introduce you four times already? By the way, this is Amelia the Pitbull-Chapman.
And this is...
I am the Mad Dog. Absolutely. Absolutely. Tonight's show, our favorite Christmas gifts. We were supposed to do, let me fill in everybody what happened here last night. We were supposed to do, this is what happens on live, when you got a live program. We were supposed to do the show last night. Okay. Then in between doing this show, we had a request from a former guest to come on.
Yes.
And... you know, and join us on the show, and we obliged that guest. However, at the last minute yesterday, that guest pooped out on us.
A few hours before it even.
Yeah, 2 hours before broadcast, that guest pooped out on us. There, well, I hope she's listening, because you'll not be invited back again. Third time's a charm, and you blew you three times. All right, kid. Yeah. So can't do it no more. But because of that, we had to push our Christmas gift show, our Christmas toy show, to tonight. Also absent tonight is the Rowdy Rev, Steve, Pastor Steve Kwiatkowski. He's out doing reverend stuff tonight. So folks, wish him well. He's got, you know, people to tend to and prayers to do and all that kind of stuff. So you're stuck with the Mad Dog and the Pit Bull doing what they do best.
Absolutely.
Pitching each other. Now,
right?
We're going to talk about our favorite Christmas. It's that time of the year, Amelia.
Absolutely.
That time of the year when everybody is just a little kinder. People are a little nicer. The food tastes a little better, and normally everybody's on their best behavior around the holidays, which is good.
It depends on that. This, you know.
Why, you got to complain about something?
Well, it's not that. It's just...
air your grievances now, woman. Do it now.
Well, it's not that. It's just like everybody. It's coming up to the last weekend before Christmas.
Yeah.
And everybody's out there to get that one Christmas present, you know, that have to have, or it's the most popular. And what if there's one left on the shelf? Everybody's going to be fighting to get it, you know.
And it's the big thing right now with little kids, especially little boys, is a thing called Roblox. I don't know what Roblox is. And then the thing for little girls is called Cocomelon.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what Cocomelon is either.
Or the latest Barbie, as they say. Or the
I don't have little kids. You know, my kids
are... the PS5 that's out right now that's like $200 that you have to buy for your children. I don't think so. You can spend the $200 on
PlayStation.
Something else.
Yes. Gee, my daughter used to... I think she still has PlayStation.
But it's a...
You
it's
have to buy like a cartridges for it, or like a...
Yes.
Is that how that works? See, I'm not a gamer. I don't know anything.
I don't either, but I know that they're like $200 to $300. Some of them are $500. Come on, really? You have to spend that much money on something like that?
The people do. And a lot more than that.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah, they sure do.
And I was like, And I was listening to Bobby Bones this morning. You know how you listen to the radio on your way to work? And they had a discussion, a husband and wife. This kid of theirs spent some money on the credit card buying some stuff for his game. He has a PS4, I guess what it is, and you have to buy credits or something to buy extra stuff for the game.
Yeah.
And he lied about it, so they got a $200 bill for their credit card.
Oh my God.
So they punished him for a month. and they bought him a PS5. So they had a debate.
Interesting.
Dad says, okay, should we go ahead and give him the gift because it's Christmas? The mom says, no, I think he's grounded, so we shouldn't give him the gift. We should return it, you know, maybe. And the dad says, well, let's go ahead and give him the gift for Christmas, but then tell him, say, let's take it away, you know.
It's interesting that you're talking about this tonight. It's very, very interesting indeed. Can I share with you and our viewers, the listeners, that just right along with what Pitbull's talking about? Listen to this one. It's funny you said that, Amelia, because I had no idea that you were going to talk about this.
Yeah.
But something in my gut told me to save this article.
Okay.
Why my husband and I canceled Christmas.
Okay.
It's true. We have canceled Christmas in our house this year. Well, at least the version of Christmas our boys have become focused on. Let me explain, she says. We have not canceled putting up decorations. We have not canceled celebrating the birth of our Lord and Savior or any of our heartwarming traditions. But we have canceled Christmas presents, Santa Claus, and stockings. Their letters to Santa this year will be asking to find some. Listen to this one.
Okay.
Their letters to Santa this year will be asking Santa to find someone who needs their presents more than they do.
Wow.
Right? Here's why, mother says. My husband John and I feel like we're fighting an uphill battle, and our kids have this sense of entitlement.
Oh.
It is one of the biggest struggles as a parent these days in middle-class America. Our kids have been acting so ungrateful lately, and they expect so much, even when their behavior is disrespectful. How many times, Amelia, have I said society is falling apart because we are rewarding bad behavior?
Absolutely. Pretty much every show that we've done, you right. said that. Every show.
Right?
Yes.
Our kids have been acting so ungrateful that they expect so much, even when their behavior is disrespectful. We gave them a warning. Either it was time for their behavior to change, or there would be consequences. We patiently worked with them for several months, and guess what? Very little changed. One day, after a particularly bad day, my husband John said, we should just cancel Christmas. And so that's what we did. Now, that's Susan and John, okay? Good idea, bad idea. What do you think?
Well, I mean, they can, you know, cancel Christmas. Yeah, but I think in a way they shouldn't cancel Christmas. They should go ahead and give the toys to, you know, maybe show the kids who doesn't have as much as they do. Maybe, I don't know, give them some Christmas gifts, but not something elaborate. You know, give them something at least under the tree. And then maybe have them help out like at a church, you know, like.
I have a question for you. Mm-hmm. I have a question for you. Okay. Keep in mind what Susan said in that letter. Mm-hmm. They have been acting like basically spoiled brats.
Yes.
You know, working with them for months and nothing's changed. She says very little has changed.
I know what they can do.
So, well, wait a minute. Here's my question for you.
Okay.
Here's my question for you. If you give them something less elaborate, what happens if you get the attitude of entitlement, which is, oh, well, I don't want that. Or what am I supposed to do with that?
Take them to an orphanage and let them show what the kids at the orphanage will have received.
Well, didn't she kind of do that anyway by saying, you know, Santa Claus is not going to deliver your presents to you. We're going to take your gifts and we're going to give them to someone else.
I would show them the who they're giving
Isn't
the gifts
that
to.
Kind of like right from the get-go, the root. I think it's the right way to go.
Oh, yeah. And show them who the gifts are going to, at least as an orphanage, and then maybe show them to have them.
Well, that's what they're saying. Yeah, they're saying. I'm going to tell you. Let me go back. I'm going to pull it up again because what she said, I have it right here.
Yes.
She says, my husband John and I felt like we were fighting a very hard uphill battle with our kids when it comes to entitlement. It's one of the biggest struggles a parent has to face these days in middle-class America. Here's the thing. You and I both come from middle class, okay?
Absolutely, yes.
We were not raised with silver spoons in our mouth.
No.
But here's the problem as I see it. The problem that John and Susan are having is this. Their kids are seeing other kids on television and in the magazines and in movies, and they see these kids living in the lap of luxury. And they have all the best, you know, high-tech gadgets and all the newfangled phones and all this other stuff.
Right.
Okay, and so they get this sense of entitlement, like, well, I deserve that too. Well, here's my father used to say, you don't deserve nothing but to wake up and go to sleep, and that's conditional.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. In other words, the only thing you're entitled to is 3 square meals a day and a place to sleep.
Yes.
That's it. And when you get old enough, you got to pay rent and you got to contribute.
Exactly. And so what they were doing is they're making them pay back the money. And so what do you think they should do? Do you think they should give them a taste of, have him open the gift and give them a taste of it and take it away, or just give it? Not even give him the gift at all until he pays back the money and unground him? Or what do you think they should do?
Well, interesting. I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask Leon Barfield to answer that question. Leon, you're in the chat room. I know that. So what do you think? What do you think of a Pitbull's suggestion? Do you give the spoiled brat a Christmas gift with conditions, or do you do what John and Susan did and tell them that their Christmas gifts are going to the underprivileged poor kids? What say you to that, Leon?
Because I know that when I was growing up, my grandmother couldn't afford much, and neither could my mom. And, you know, back then, you know, you could go to bingo and win money. And that's what my grandmother did every year.
Right?
She would go to bingo and, sure. She had 30 grandkids, my grandmother, believe it or not. And so she would buy us little gifts here and there. They wouldn't cost much. And, you know, we were happy.
You're talking about a time, though.
Yes.
When you could get a bunch of gifts for, you know, relatively cheap.
Yeah. And you know? We were happy because we got something under the tree with our name on it. We could open
something
it and
to
have
open.
Fun. That's exactly.
It. That's what a need is real big about.
Yes.
My wife, Anita, is very, very big about having something for somebody to open.
Absolutely. And have something extra. If anybody comes to visit you, at least they have, you have an extra gift for somebody to have.
Absolutely.
Unexpectedly. Yep. Yes.
Yeah. And that's how Anita is. She wants, yes. You know, she wants, you know, everybody that has. Leon says John and Susan are right. Damn straight they are.
Yeah.
Absolutely. I agree.
Return it.
Too.
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe here's my conditions here, mm-hmm. or my stipulations. I would say, okay, if you want a Christmas gift and if you want it to be given freely and with love, earn
yes,
it.
Absolutely.
By what you do during the year. Okay, here you go. Here's the stipulation and condition. If you're a spoiled, rotten brat leading up to Christmas, I will give you a gift in accordance with your level of behavior. Okay? So if you're going to be a spoiled brat, I may wrap up a slice of cheese. Okay?
Yes.
And put it in a box for you to open. Now, what are you going to get? You're going to get a slice of cheese. Well, it stinks, isn't it? Because it's in a box.
Right.
Well, you can eat it, can't you? Sure you can.
It depends when you open it, though. It could be molded and yucky.
That's my point. Spoiled rotten is my point. You get
right?
me?
Yes.
You get where I'm going with this?
Yes, okay. Absolutely.
You caught on pretty quick to that one.
But the toys nowadays are nothing like what we had when we were growing up. Oh, my
God. You're going to see something tonight. Leon, let's see, I'm going to bring Leon up here. Leon says, however, they should get the spoiled kids some stuff, not expensive.
Yes.
Well, but Leon, whether it's expensive or not, isn't that rewarding bad behavior, my friend?
Yeah.
And so that was my whole point from the get-go was, don't give them anything. If they're going to be like little snot noses, well, you get them nothing. You take the children, you bring them to the homeless shelter, and you let them see how the other half is living.
Yes, exactly.
But kids that don't have a Christmas tree.
Don't have anything, don't have parents, don't have...
Do you know that, and I'm not saying this to toot my own horn. Many years ago, I played Santa Claus for a family that didn't have any money, that didn't have much going for them. You would have thought that I walked in there with $1 million, and all I had, Amelia, was a box with some food.
Right.
I had a turkey, some canned food, some fresh stuffing, stuff like that for them to make for dinner.
Mm-hmm.
Right? They had enough food to last for a week.
Oh, wow.
Okay? In one box. Do you know how far a turkey will go?
Oh, yes. Absolutely.
Okay? I'll bet you they ate turkey for 4 or 5 days. Yes. At least 4 days anyway.
Yes. There's so much you can do with the turkey. Absolutely.
Leon says, Leon's one of these people like you, Pitbull. Yes. Leon says, I think everyone should get something for the holiday. And you know what, Leon? Honestly, I kind of agree with you there, but I think the level of what you get depends on how rotten of a snot nose you're being.
But it's like if don't give them toys. Give them, like, underwear. Give them socks. Give them something.
Wait,
you know,
a minute.
You know?
Socks and underwear are great Christmas gifts.
Yeah, they are.
You know why? Especially for me, because I hate going out and buying socks and underwear.
Yeah. Right?
I want somebody to buy them for me so I don't have to go out and buy them.
Yeah, you have to go in their undershirts, you know, anything like that anybody can use.
Absolutely. Are you kidding me? Please.
Or teach that kid a lesson and go buy blankets, go buy scarves, and say, here you go, here you go.
Yeah.
So homeless people say that this person was, you want a $200-something gift? This person can't afford a $200 gift, but you know what? They would love a scarf any day of the week, any day of the year during this holiday season that it's cold out.
What are your favorite Christmas gifts? What are some of your favorite toys you got when you were a kid? The chat is open. Join us. We are in conversation. Leon's in the chat with us tonight, our friend
you
Leon Barfield.
You want to ask that more after the first commercial break and come back?
How about that? Let's do a commercial first. Well, I'm proud of you tonight. You're on it. Man, I don't know what to do. I'm like besides myself. The Pitbull is actually on it tonight. And in honor of you being like on the ball,
yes,
I'm going to play your favorite commercial for you.
Oh, right? No. Please.
Just wanted to start a business when something surprising happened.
Today, I'm going to teach you how to crochet.
She started crocheting, like a lot. And her friends noticed.
Jess, you need to sell those.
So she signed up for Shopify and started building her business.
Yes, I love that.
And after a lot of hard work, this happened.
Oh my gosh, I just made my first sale!
You see, every day, hundreds of businesses get their first sale on Shopify.
We got dang!
And the next could be you. So when you're ready to bring your idea to life
and become your own boss,
build it on Shopify.
Do you have sweaty balls or volleyball netty balls? It's time to make them ready balls. The Manscaped.com Lawnmower 3.0 will do the job and clean your knob with its patented no-nick head, so your head will function as desired. Enter promo code WrestlingFuture for a generous 20% discount. That's enter WrestlingFuture for a 20% discount manscaped.com. And wrestling with the future, going balls to the walls with manscaped.com. And the Lawnmower 3.0, your balls will thank you. And so will we.
You're gonna die.
Siguro lagi nakatingin. Masino na lamang ang magagawa. Inaabangan ako na mawala. Kaso lang ang malala na dapa kakatingala.
Game?
Sa kapunta to the moon. Road trip. Vroom vroom. Star skr. Zoom zoom.
No time better up. I can help. Let's not let me get ahead of myself. Put your bow mind. Tell me you don't wanna get shot. Why so still you get the lotto intel? Why still with me? I'm bothered.
What's the buzz, America's Best Podcast? On the record, WWTF Radio presents tonight a very special show, our favorite Christmas gifts. Joining me, the Pitbull herself, the mouth of the South, the pain in the arse. I mean, what other adjectives we have for you? The mouth that roared.
Right?
Right? That's funny.
Right? And Angelo, my dog, sure. Scipio.
As we were coming back, Leon says, last year, I got a pair of socks and a sweater. I got news for you, Leon. A lot of people love to have a sweater and a pair of socks. I love sweaters. I wear sweaters all the time.
I like going to CVS and seeing all the socks that they have in those little bins. And I was like, ooh, I like this color. I like this color.
Absolutely. So let me ask you a question, Mia.
Yes.
Some of it, your favorite, first of all, I got to ask you the million-dollar question. Have to ask everybody because it's Christmas time. When did you stop believing in Santa?
Let's see here. Hopefully there's no little kids in the room.
No, don't worry about it. I think they're all adults right now. All the kids,
I think, maybe when I was 10, 11 years old, I think.
That seems to be the magic age, isn't it?
Yes.
It seems to be like between 9 and 11 seem to be like the Santa cutoff. I don't know what you want to call it. You know?
Yeah, because everybody realizes
the end of the fantasy.
Right. They realize it's mom and dad.
You see, and I don't know what it is about that age, but and I think perhaps some of it might be the responsibility or the fault, depending on which word you want to use, of the media.
Yes.
Because kids at that age are getting like smart to what's happening.
Oh yeah, they do.
You know, and so maybe they, you know, they're listening more to the media and you know, things around them, the people around them, the parents and aunts and uncles.
Their kids.
Other kids, you know, their friends and neighbors, you know. Because it seems to work like this. It only takes one kid to say, you know, I don't believe in Santa anymore. Right?
Right.
And then everybody is like, they jump on the band. It's like a Me Too.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's like a Me Too. It's like jump on the bandwagon. Well, what happens if that kid is like 30 or 40 years old now and they still believe in Santa Claus? And I don't mean the person. Right. I mean the idea of being kind and generous and having a smile on your face. Because the whole idea of Santa, It started out, people don't understand this. Santa Claus started out as a marketing stunt.
Yes.
But lo and behold, guess what? He was based on a real person. His name was Saint Nicholas of Tursos. And he was a Greek. He was a priest in the Greek Orthodox Church. And he used to put toys and they were called toys, but they were gifts.
Yes.
He used to put gifts in stockings that were hanging out on the fireplace to dry.
Oh.
And that's how the stocking tradition came about. And the idea of calling Santa Claus Saint Nicholas is absolutely right in line with the folklore and the truth. It's kind of a, you know, a fascinating thing, but yeah, Santa was a real person. But who created Santa Claus, the advertising gimmick? You're going to laugh when I tell you. You may not know. Mm-hmm. It was created by Coca-Cola.
Really?
An artist for the Coca-Cola company came up with Santa Claus. What would Santa Claus look like? Okay?
Yes.
He would have to be big and fat and jolly. What color is appealing to kids? Red. Everybody
red. Red. Yeah, because it stands out.
Right. Red and white. Well, think about it. What color are candy canes? Red and white.
And white. And then Coca-Cola, the logo there is red and white as well.
There you go. Well, you're smart tonight. Wow. I don't know. I'm going to have to like give her a raise or something. Like, she's really getting smart tonight. Coca-Cola had a red and white logo. Holy shit. Let's see. Where we got? Leon says, you were 7. I asked parents and they told me, well, no kidding.
They told them Leon, the truth at 7?
That takes a lot of chutzpah, baby.
Wow.
You asked them when you were 7 and they actually told you the truth. You know, it's interesting. I applaud Leon's parents for doing that. Because most kids would have just lied to you.
Yeah.
And made up some other story. You know?
Oh, yeah, because they would be like, you know, taking their kids to go see Santa at the mall, or there's a place where they put this kid on an elevator and it goes up in the sky. Have you seen that commercial?
I have, yes.
And yeah. It's a cute little commercial, and then you open the door and there's like Santa, and I was like, oh my God, that is so cute for little kids.
Yeah.
I even like
Leon it. Says some people need Krampus more than Santa.
I've seen that. Yeah, they do.
If you don't know what Krampus is an evil bastard.
Yeah, you don't want that one.
No, Krampus is bad. You don't want Krampus. Krampus is bad.
The movie is even scary.
So, what were your favorite Christmas stories?
I remember one time my sister and I can't remember how old we were. I think we were, I was 12, and I don't remember how old she was, but we gave each other the same teddy bear for Christmas.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, the same teddy bear, same sweater, everything. It was just the cutest little thing. That was one of my favorites. And then one time my grandfather was shopping at the, I don't know if it was at Walmart or somewhere. And my grandfather, I was 15 at the time. So my sister and I are 3 years apart. And out of all the grandkids, the granddaughter, everything, he stopped and he bought me and my sister some makeup from this lady that was just out there selling it. And my grandfather never bought, on my mom's side of the family, he never bought anything for kids or anything like that. But he thought of me and my sister and bought us makeup with some eyeshadow, the palette that comes with them.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that interesting? All little girls love makeup.
Oh, yeah.
That's the one thing. They don't. All little girls do not love baby dolls, but they all love makeup.
Yeah, and so I thought of all the things that he stopped and thought of me and my sister and bought us this little thing with eyeshadows, with, you know, blush and some little lipstick thing. And he just bought it for us just because. Just because.
My
it happened to be
favorite
Christmas
gift as a kid.
Mm-hmm.
'Cause I love to take things apart and put things together.
Yeah.
My favorite Christmas gift, I remember it like it was yesterday, was I asked for a what's called an erector set. Now, you probably don't know what that is.
No.
Okay. Leon will know what an erector set is. An erector set is, today it's very different than it used to be, but it used to be wood and metal.
Oh.
And you would make things with it. You could make buildings. You could make airplanes that would fly with a propeller. Oh.
Wow.
And it had all kinds of like little motors and everything. You could take it apart and make something else. But because it was made of metal back in the day, as the company got older and things got, you know, more safety conscious.
Right.
That became made out of plastic now instead of metal and wood. It became just like just made out of plastic. But they still gave you like little motors, you know, that, that make it fly or whatever the thing. But anyway, and I should find this. I'm going to find it during the show.
Yeah.
Anything
else that was your favorite?
Oh, no, that was my favorite. But then I also, I loved when I got a radio.
Oh, yes.
For Christmas. Oh, Leon's here. Let me see. Leon, you remember? Leon says, yep, but I never had one. I did, Leon. I had an Erector set. And Leon knows what I'm talking about. They were made, they were metal, and you would have, Amelia, they came with screws and bolts and nuts and a little screwdriver, and it was like it was like a man's
right
like stuff, you know. But they marketed this shit for little kids, and I loved it because I love to put, you know, things together and take things apart. The same applied to the radio that I got too.
Oh wow!
I had to take it apart, see how it made it work. I did. And don't laugh. And I put it back together again, and it still worked.
That's good.
I even had some extra parts left.
And you were like, okay, what are these for?
Oh, no. That's the funny thing. I knew what everything was for. Mm-hmm. It was very strange. I love to take shit apart. Mm-hmm. I still do today. Mm-hmm. You got to see my toolbox and my workbench. I love taking shit apart and putting it back together. Because when I put it back together, I always have parts left over that you don't need.
Right. Sometimes they give you parts that you don't need.
Because they always give you extra shit that you'll never use.
Right.
That's the thing. People don't understand that. But I tell you what, that was a great Christmas. I remember that was at my grandmother's house. When we were younger, we moved from Philadelphia to New Jersey. And at the time, we still had things, you know, furniture and clothing in both states.
Right.
So we were moving things from, you know, Philadelphia over to New Jersey. And it happened to be that Christmas time this particular year was one of those times where it overlapped.
Right.
Because we were moving into New Jersey, I think, that February. So we were moving things over. But so I celebrated Christmas at my grandmother's house, which I always considered a second home anyway, because I love that place.
Oh, yes.
And my other favorite gift that I ever got for Christmas was a set of drums that my cousin was so jealous of that he took a knife and cut the fucking drum skins.
How rude.
I'm not making that up.
That's horrible.
I'm not making that up. Yep. My father wanted to kill him. Ugh. He wanted to kill. He said, "You son of a bitch, you little motherfucker, you bastard."
I would have said, "That is an expensive gift. How dare you?" I would have made him work for that at the restaurant.
Oh, man, are you kidding? He was a miserable. Now, the same guy today, and he's a year older than me, my cousin Tommy, he's a year older than me, but you would never know that he has a jealous bone in his body. But when he was a kid, he was jealous of everything. If you got something, he had to have it.
Or destroy it because he didn't have
it. Or destroy it because he didn't have it. Yeah, exactly.
Wow.
Because I took drum lessons when I was a kid.
Right.
And that was my drum set, you know?
Yeah. And I think I got that Mr. Microphone, and my mom know that I love to sing.
Every kid had Mr. Microphone.
Because I love to sing. Sylvia was my favorite, still my favorite singer. So
I'll tell you what we're going to do. Let me run a spot here. Let me do this. Let me run a promo spot for your wrestling show.
Okay.
And then when we come back, I'll do the next set of commercials, okay? And then I'll show you and Leon and everybody else listening and watching some of the favorite toys of yesteryear.
Yes.
Okay, we'll be right back, folks, right after this. On the record with the Pitbull and the Mad Dog on WWTF Radio, What's the Buzz, America's Best Podcast. Amelia, talking about some of our favorite Christmas memories, our favorite Christmas gifts. Here you go. I'll throw a curveball at you. What one gift did you absolutely hate? The one gift, if you had to give it back at that moment, that you would have gave it back.
I think Barbie doll. I was not into Barbie dolls.
I don't think that you're a doll person, no.
I was not, no.
You don't strike me as a Barbie doll person.
No. I was more into the music, anything like that music-wise. Or
You do strike me, though, as maybe like an easy-bake oven
not
person.
Really? Yeah.
No shit. Really? You'd rather like... do something different, huh?
Yeah, I was more into jewelry, anything for my hair, makeup, music, albums. I loved albums.
And when you were a kid, too, you still loved like the music and that kind of
stuff?
Oh,
yes.
Interesting stuff, isn't it?
I would stay in my room and listen to music, play my albums, sing on my Mr. Microphone, and I have fun. Or if not, I made my own microphone until I got my Mr. Microphone.
Yeah, you know what people used to do? Take a hairbrush and sink into it.
Yeah.
That's a big thing.
Or I'd get a pen.
Sink into the mirror in a hairbrush.
Or I'd get a pen and, you know, masking tape, and I'd put like a paper towel on top of the masking tape and make my own microphone.
Yeah. Here's the microphone here. Marker.
Right?
Marker. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's take our second set of breaks here. We'll be right back, and we're going to take a look at memories of Christmas days gone by. We'll be right back, folks.
Step one, train the people only to consume. Step two, infiltrate adults with the news. Step three, indoctrinate the children through the schools and the music and the apps on the phones that they use. Step four, separate the right from the left. Step five, separate the white from the black. Step six, separate the rich from the poor. Use religion and equality to separate them more. Step seven, fabricate a problem made a lie. Step eight, put it on the news every night. Step nine, when people start to fight and divide, take control. This is called situational design.
We've made iHeartRadio the fastest growing music app in the U.S. Why? Because we connect you to all of your favorite music and radio stations in one free app. And this fall, prepare to take control of how you listen to the radio.
Replay.
That song on your radio you just can't hear enough? Immediately replay and sing along again.
Save.
Save the music you love on the radio directly to your playlist.
Play.
Search for and play any song on demand.
Skip.
Unlimited skips.
Offline.
Take the music from your favorite stations offline. Introducing iHeartRadio Plus and iHeartRadio All Access. Your radio now on demand.
What's the Buzz Podcast wants to welcome Radioactive FM 88.6 in Wellington, New Zealand, Radio Perth, Australia, and RTL Radio 102.5 in Milan, Italy. Welcome aboard, and welcome to the Buzz.
Hey, Max, what's going on? I'm X, and from this moment on, I'm going to be your own personal AI DJ on Spotify. Let's go. Up next, I know you've been on a summer song kick lately, so I went back for some of your old summertime favorites. See if it warms you up. next up, some of the music you had on a lot back in 2018.
Do you think of me?
All right, Max, let's get you out of your feels and switch up the vibe. You've been into dance music lately. I got this brand new release to get you moving. Introducing DJ, the best of Spotify made just for you, one tap away. Powered by AI, delivered by me, your very own DJ.
What's the buzz? America's Best Popcast tonight on the record with some of our favorite Christmas gifts. I am the pit. I'm not the people. I am the man.
You're the mad dog.
You can tell what kind of night this was with her. I am the mad dog. She's the pit bull. I'm the pit bull because I'm looking at you over here. All right. We're back.
Yes.
When last we left off, Leon says for him it was sports stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Baseball and football cards. Leon, let's talk about that. Did you ever get a baseball or football card pack that had something very valuable in it? I know you had a... Leon told us last night about a Mickey Mantle card that he sold for $400. You know, you realize, Leon, you would have been a millionaire today.
Oh, yeah.
Had you kept that card. Oh, my God. Especially if it was a Mickey rookie card.
Yes.
Mickey Mantle. Oh, my God. Please. We would have been saying... You know, Leon is the guy that gives Trump money, you know? It would be like Donald Who, calling Leon Barfield Mr. President, you know?
I told my dad, I said, keep an eye on your cards and find out what you got, because he's got a lot of baseball cards.
All right. Well, Leon, I'll tell you what, Leon, you did all right, though. I think you made a good investment with your... $400, it lasted you a couple of hours anyway.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I hope it lasted you a couple of hours anyway.
Right.
Anyway, so let's take a look at this. I have a video, and I think that it's very telling when you look at some of these vintage toys now. To me, they still look as fresh as the day they came on the market, because I remember these toys.
Yes.
If you tried, the problem being my age, if you try to explain to someone younger what these toys are, you can't. Could no one will understand.
Oh, yeah. I know what you mean.
Just won't. Well, let's take a look at this, Mealy. Watch this.
Okay.
Let's talk about this. This is called Mystery Date.
Yes.
Now, if you don't know what the idea here with Mystery Date is, there was a game that came back in the 1950s and 60s, right?
Right.
That was a big deal. And then it went away for a while, but then something remarkable happened. A movie came out called The Santa Claus with Tim Allen.
Yes.
And in the movie, the woman wanted Mystery Date. Okay?
Right.
Well, guess what? Because of that, Mystery Date revived their game. Now, it comes complete with a cell phone.
Yeah. Of all things, a cell phone.
Make pretend cell phone. It has an electronic talking phone. It talks to you, but you can't talk back.
Right.
So, yeah, it's really interesting stuff. This was... Now, Leon, you'll remember this because you're close to my age. Amelia, there was a TV show 1 year ago called Lost in Space.
Yes.
Okay. Now, I know you're way too young to remember this. I don't even know if you may have seen them on reruns, but I've heard of the show.
Yes.
Okay. They did a movie called Lost in Space. Mm-hmm. Okay. With Natalie Portman. She was in it. And that movie was based on this TV series from back in the 60s. It was about a family that literally gets lost in space.
Right.
And so now the series takes you through their adventures. Okay. This is one of the main characters in the show. This is the robot. The voice of the robot is the same guy that is the voice of Tony the Tiger for cornflakes, Kellogg's cornflakes.
Oh,
you know, the guy that goes, they're great, you know. Yeah. He's also, by the way, the same guy that sings You're a Mean One, Mr. Grinch.
Oh, wow.
His name is Theo Thermopolis.
Okay.
So, not that you will ever remember that, Amelia, so just don't even go, okay.
Okay.
I know like, you okay. won't. Just sit there and shake your head.
Theo Thermopolis. Okay.
There you go. Now, this is... This was another toy that they sold, part of the Lost in Space TV series. This is what the family traveled around in. Okay? And it was their, like, their space mobile or whatever you want to call it.
A little car like we would have.
Yeah. Right here. Mm-hmm. One of everybody's favorites is Mr. Potato Head.
Yes.
Now, Mr. Potato Head has gone through a lot of different changes over the years.
Yes, it has.
Mr. Potato Head was black. Mr. Potato Head was brown. Mr. Potato Head was white. Mr. Potato Head had sharp appendages. Then he had dull appendages.
Right.
Then he had a pipe. And then he didn't have a pipe because the Mr. Potato Head didn't want children to see him smoking. This is the kind of shit we're talking about. And this is what Mr. Potato... Leon, are you watching this stuff? Look at this. This is Mr. Potato Head from 2021
mm-hmm.
to what he looked like back in the 1970s.
What a big difference. Look at that.
Oh, it's day and night.
Yeah.
One is a white Mr. Potato Head. The other one is a black one.
Mm.
You'll notice, look at the hat.
The hat, yeah.
Look at the hat that the black Mr. Potato Head is wearing. Could it scream racism anymore?
Right.
You know?
And then, if God forbid you accidentally step on that hat on the floor.
If you stepped on that hat, it was going to go right through your foot.
It's like, ow!
Now, this is Mr. Potato Head and Mrs. Potato Head. Did you ever see the movie Toy Story?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Okay. Mr. and Mrs. Potato Head are a big part of that show, that movie. Now, when I was a kid, I had one of these. And Leon, you'll know what these were. This is G.I. Joe with the Kung Fu Grip. Oh, did you have one? Leon, did you have one as a child? The 70s version of Potato Head? That's pretty cool. There were a lot of different versions of G.I. Joe.
Yes.
Including this one here, which was the classic Kung Fu Grip. Of course, then you got Play-Doh. That's an old standard.
Absolutely. Yes, I remember having that as a kid.
They've been around forever. Play-Doh. Of course, you know, everybody, you have Play-Doh,
yes.
But now you have to have the Play-Doh kit.
The kit,
so
yes.
You can make stuff, right?
Yes.
Now, look at that. It's got all kinds of stuff in there you can make. That's the food. That's a Play-Doh kitchen, it's called. It's got pizza. It's got hamburger.
The roller thing. You can roll.
That's good. Yeah, it's got rollers in it.
Mm-hmm.
It's got all kinds of stuff to make toppings for, like, French fries and... Here you go.
Yep.
This is part of the Play-Doh kitchen. It's an actual blender. Now, if you don't have one of these as a little boy, then you didn't live. Because this was the official Batmobile from the TV series Batman.
Oh, wow.
And how much do you think they sold for?
Probably $10 back then.
Back then? Mm-hmm. How about 75 cents?
Really?
75 Whoa. Cents.
Yep. Wow.
It came in a plastic container. You open it up and you played with it. 75 mm-hmm. cents. Ah, here you go.
Yeah.
Now, classic is absolutely right. This is the easy bake oven. Now, what made this thing work? Take a guess, Amelia. What made it work?
Batteries, probably?
No, a light bulb.
A light bulb, really?
You plugged it into the wall, and you put a light bulb in it, and the light bulb would actually cook a cake.
Like the ones that you get like from like the stove, like one of those?
No, like a regular light bulb that you put in a lamp.
Oh, no, wow. A regular light bulb or something. Oh.
Yeah, look, and they would actually, you could make cakes with them.
Wow.
And don't laugh, but they were pretty good.
Yeah, I bet they were, though.
Yeah, they really were. Leon, you were born in 67, so you're a few years younger than me. A lot younger than I am. Let's see. Leon, what else? Remember the getting fuzzy pamper barbershop? Yep, light bulb. See? Mm-hmm. Leon had it right. Light bulb.
Yeah.
Give the man a prize. Give him an easy bake oven. Yeah. Now, if that wasn't enough, it gets better. Because now, there were variations of easy bake oven. And that had a light bulb inside it. Now, this one here, the new one.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, this is the new one. And I think, Amelia, this one may have batteries. I'm not sure.
Because I think the one that my daughter had, it was a pink one. I think that one just needed batteries. I don't think it needed the light bulb or something like that.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Don't quote me on it. Mm-hmm. But I think that might be right. Now, again, the Santa Claus movie with Tim Allen.
Yes.
You saw this toy in that movie, Toss Across. Sure enough, people were asking for Toss Across. Guess what?
Yeah, they brought it back.
There it is. Yep. Everybody wanted Toss Across. And there was another perennial favorite. Leon, I'm sure you'll remember this one. Mr. Yep. Microphone.
That was mine.
Amelia had 12 of them.
I did not. I just had one.
That's the new Mr. Microphone. Look at that.
Wow. I don't think I could. That's like a lot of little knobs on it. I'll be like, okay, what?
Oh, it's very easy to work. Believe me. Very, very easy. This is Twister. Did you see that one?
Yeah, that one I could do as a kid. Now.
Yeah, Twister. You took your life in your hands with Twister.
Yeah.
Because that game could put you in the hospital.
Yeah. That nowadays, I could not. Nope.
Especially like at my age. Mm-hmm. Like you try to do that, you're going to end up in traction.
Not with me now. After my car accident, I could not do that anymore.
No, Amelia, you can. You try to do that, you're dead. Forget it.
Right.
You may as well just take Amelia and roll her up inside the game.
Say bye.
Yeah, exactly. Tonka toys were always one of my favorites. Yeah. I put this picture up here because I had that truck.
Yes, my son had that. My Joseph had that when he was little, and my sister had that because you can't find the metal trucks anymore. It's all plastic.
They're all plastic now. I had the metal one.
Yes.
Now, let's see if I don't think Leon remembers this one because I don't think Leon was old enough. This is called, and I'm not making this up.
It sounds like he had a Tonka truck, too. He says, had one.
Yeah. Yep. Tonka, for sure. Oh, Tonka's still, they're still around, too.
Yes.
This is Albert the Drinking Duck. Now, what do you think, Amelia? What do you think Albert did?
Pretend to drink the water, I guess.
Well, you're kind of sort of close, yeah. Let me show you what's inside the box first, and then I'll explain it to you. because you're going to laugh at this.
Oh, my God. Really? Sorry.
That's Albert the Drinking Duck. Now, let me explain this. In case you don't know what's going on here. Okay. You see that tube? There's a tube.
Yes.
Okay. Inside that tube is mercury.
Ah.
Not the safest thing you want to give a kid, mercury.
Not really. Yeah.
Okay. Well, the mercury, can't make this up, folks. The mercury, if once you tip Albert the duck, he goes like this back and forth. His beak goes like this into the water. Okay? You see his beak there?
Yes.
The only thing that's moving him is the mercury inside that tube because it's constantly moving. And it'll move until you stop it.
What were they thinking giving that to a kid?
What were they thinking is the magic question. I have no idea. I would never think to give... by the way, it's made out of metal, too, by the way.
Exactly. What were
I
they...
would never think to give a kid
mm-hmm.
a metal duck, a duck shaped out of, metal...
Mm-hmm.
Probably like steel or something like that.
Right. I guess they thought we were made of tougher skin back then.
But no, they didn't think.
Said, that was that too.
No, they didn't. You know how many kids got hurt with this shit?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, man.
I mean, nowadays we step on Legos. That hurts. But imagine the metal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, Leon. That's it, kid. Be thankful you were born in 67 because
mm-hmm.
I lived through all that stuff. I got hurt plenty on that shit. I did too. I really
especially
did.
Especially with those Tonka trucks when the metal starts rusting out. We didn't think about it back then. We still played. My sister still played with it and she didn't care.
Tell everybody, Amelia, what's coming up this week.
Oh, Friday we have Johnny Whitaker on our show. It will be his... Well, actually, we'll be celebrating his birthday as well. We'll have him as a guest again for the second time. We'll be discussing, part two, talking about what he's been up to as well. And talking just about childhood, more about him, basically, what he's been up to.
Yeah. Yeah. It's his birthday. We're going to
say happy birthday to him. Yes. Absolutely.
Talk a little bit about his career.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to get inside Johnny Whitaker, the man.
Yeah,
I want to know.
We're
going
to talk about more about what he's been up to since his acting career.
Yeah. Since he's been here.
A little bit about his career.
A little bit. I'm not going to dwell on his career.
No.
And what else we got coming up?
18th and 19th of December, which is next Monday and Tuesday, we'll be showing you the best of our end of our year show, actually.
The best of 2023.
Yes. We're going to be putting some shows together for you guys. We wanted to bring all of our shows, but we had to kind of like pick some. And
there were so many. Honestly, there were so many. What Amelia's trying to say to you is there really were so many to pick from that I could only pick 7.
Yes.
Because we would have had a 3-hour show. Or a 5-hour show. But
of our shows are their favorite.
Yeah. If I took just 2 minutes from every show I wanted to.
We'd be here 3 hours or more.
I would have had a 3-4-hour show easy.
Yes.
And I can't do that.
Right.
First of all, I don't want to be here for 3 or 4 hours. Right.
But we appreciate every single one of you.
2 hours is about my cutoff point. Right? And then I want to go away.
But we appreciate every single one of you, of all the guests that we have had on our show. And continue
to
have.
Without our audience, we are
and our audience as well. We appreciate every single one of you to tuning in every single Monday and Tuesday.
Yep. Especially people like Leon that's a steadfast with us. Leon's been with us since the beginning. Thankfully, thank you, Leon.
Yes.
And so we're also coming up on Amelia's anniversary.
Yes.
It's going to be bittersweet because she's getting her own show, which means she will be leaving this show. And so she will be doing the wrestling show, but she can't get rid of me because I'm going to be doing a wrestling show with her.
I'm not really leaving this show, but
I'm leaving, but you're going to a different show.
Yeah, but I'll be here on some of the shows as well.
Well, too. Some of them.
Yes.
That I want you to be.
He wants me to be, so he's kicking me out.
I'm just gonna like keep you. I'll put your
get me the boot. There. You know.
Yeah. I'll just put Amelia's like emoji there.
Yeah, I'll be 2 year anniversary actually.
2 years. Do we know exactly what date it was? I think it might have been the 12th.
The January show that I did with you as a guest was at the end of January when we.
Oh, was
did.
The end? Oh, you yes. know what? Mm-hmm. It might have. Yeah, we have to go and look at the actual.
Yeah.
The actual date.
And we've had so much fun though throughout the year. Teasing each other, making each other laugh but stuff like that. But he's taught me so much. And I know
Leon's making you a promise. He says, I will be in the chat for the wrestling show. Good, perfect. Leon. You can bug for a while. She's a pain in the ass.
He might teach me a few things too along the way.
Yeah, like how to shut up, how to remain quiet.
Oh, really? I think he might teach you to shut up. See, folks? He's going to miss me on this show.
Please. All right. Here's what we're going to do. We are going to say goodnight to everybody.
Yes.
And till next week. Be good to everybody.
Yes.
Your friends, neighbors. Be kind. Yes. It's that time of the year. Let's just talk serious for a second.
Yes.
It's that time of the year. And I want everybody to kind of show a little bit of kindness. Just a little. And it doesn't have to be a lot. A smile while you keep your mouth shut, while you're gritting your teeth. A smile goes a long way.
Right.
You can see that. You can grit your teeth and see
mm-hmm.
and still smile.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean you have to be a miserable bastard and open your mouth.
And it's the last weekend before Christmas to do your last minute shopping.
It is.
And just because there's one little toy left or whatever it is, don't be fighting people over for it. Come on.
Yeah. And listen, do yourself a favor. I want everybody to do something for me. Do this for me. Do it for Amelia. Do it for everybody here at the shop. Take a plastic bag. I want you to put a can of food in that bag. Put a can opener. Put a $5 bill. Go to the dollar store and buy a cheap blanket. Put it in that bag, too. Seal up that bag and give it to somebody homeless if you see them.
Yes.
Keep it in the back seat of your car. And if you see somebody that needs it, give it to them. Okay? And what's it costing you? Virtually nothing.
Nothing.
Okay? Do that. A little kindness goes a long, long way, folks.
Absolutely.
On behalf of Leon Barfield, our man in the chat, on behalf of Amelia, the Pitbull Chapman, who I bust her chops daily, I love you.
Yeah, and me too.
You know that, I do this because it's easy and it's fun.
It is fun, isn't it?
Well, I give you a lot of shit, I give her a lot of crap. and you take it like a champ, but thank you for that. And I'm folks, on behalf of myself, Mad Dog DeCipio, have a very Merry Christmas. We'll see you next week. And then we won't see you until after January.
Yeah.
Take care. God bless everybody. Good night. Bye-bye.
Good night.